Hey guys, so there has been a lot happening in the last week. Obviously, the government stimulus, the second stimulus has been released, as well as the banks are getting involved, as well as even the state governments have released their own stimulus for each state as well. So we just want to quickly go over what the benefits are and what issues they may have with payroll and with the employees. We've been compiling as much information as we can. We've been putting it on our website, boxas.com.au/news/COVID-19. I would also put a link out there for you guys to click on so you can get some information. So let's just jump right into it. So the first things first is the government stimulus package. Now, I know last week I did speak about the first government stimulus package and I said it's not really a cash grab. Now, for small business owners, they're basically giving a grant. So the grants that initially they were giving for cash flow and for payroll and employees was $2,000. So they're giving a minimum of $2,000 all the way up to $50,000. And it was to cover your tax withholding that you're paying for your employees. And they were gonna be rebating 50% back to the small business owners in their BASs. So what they've essentially done now in the second stimulus package is upped that to $100,000. And on top of that, increase the minimum payout to $20,000. So let me just quickly explain how this works again. So basically, throughout the year, you will be lodging business activity statements, whether it's on a monthly basis or a quarterly basis for your small business. And if you employ employees, they haven't really determined what type of employees, whether it's closely held employees, so family members within the business, or external employees, they basically said any employees, you'll be entitled to this grant, and that grant is $20,000 minimum all the way up to 100k. And how that works is that if, for example, you pay $100,000 in wages, and that $100,000 in wages throughout the year in your business activity statements, when you lodge it, you'll pay roughly around 25k per quarter. In that 25k per quarter, you would have had to pay some taxes to the government for your PAYG tax withholding. And this is your employee's wages tax. So when you pay that employee's wages tax, the government's basically going to give you a refund. And if that refund does not equate to $20,000, that will push that up to $20,000 and give you the minimum of 20K for your business. So yes, now this is a cash grab. Reason being is because if you pay, you know, only $50,000 in wages through the year and your tax withholding is less to none, like zero, you will still get that $20,000 cash grab and you'll still get that grant from the government. So this is really, really beneficial. And how it works is you don't need to register, because once you pay PAYG already, you're already registered with the government. All you need to do is lodge your business activity statements, and you don't get the $20,000 straight away. You basically get this payment of 20K throughout your BASs you've lodged. So you lodged your March BAS, your April to June BAS, and your July to September BAS, those three quarters. So the first March BAS, you'll get $10,000. So once you've lodged a BAS, and that BAS will more than likely be lodged in April or May, you would get a $10,000 refund into your bank account. The next BAS that you lodge will be the April to June, and that will be lodged around July and August, and you will also get a grant, and that grant will be $5,000. And from that last BAS that you lodge from July to September, which will be lodged in October or November, that grant will be an extra $5,000, which adds up to your 20K that you're going to get. So that's basically how that works for micro businesses and those businesses that are employing just a small number of staff and doesn't have much PAYG withholding. So that is amazing. So then what that's going to be doing for small businesses is giving them that extra amount of money for them to pay their employees and keep their employees within the payroll. The thing is, this has nothing to mention about reducing the payroll and reducing the hours of employees. So I actually think that you can probably, if cash flow isn't doing so well and the business doesn't require that many employees, you can more than likely reduce your payroll and keep it down low. You don't have to worry about having all employees in place just to get this up to 100k grant from the government. But take note, if you're planning to let some people go or you're planning to reduce the hours, you have to follow the right rules. And we actually released a lot of information about this, and you can find it on the Fair Work website. I will have a link in the resource page for you. So with the supporting apprentices and trainees, that act is still happening. So you're basically going to get 50% of the wages of the trainee or in the apprentice of up to 21K. There's no changes with that. So that's basically it for the cash flow for small business owners in terms of the grants that the government's giving us. There are some other benefits. So what the benefit the government's also giving is that they want to guarantee up to 50% of business loans that the banks are giving to small business owners. So if you're planning to get a loan just to make sure that you can survive for the next 6 months to 12 months during this coronavirus epidemic, then it might be a good idea to look at getting this. And what you need to do is actually speak to the banks. So most of the major banks are offering this service. So speak to your bank, ask them about this offer where you are not personally guaranteeing all the business loans, and the government will personally guarantee up to 50% of the loan that you're borrowing from the banks. Definitely something very helpful, and I'm sure my business will also be looking into this. So as I mentioned before, instant asset write-off of up to 150K still applies and still useful. Again, like I mentioned before though, it's not a cash grab. You're not gonna get money. What it is, you have to spend money and get accelerated depreciation for that year up to 2020 financial year. So you're gonna get that tax deduction claimed against your profits, but if you're not making any profits, you're essentially just pushing yourself into a bigger loss. So be careful with this. It's actually not that useful if you're not really making that money and there's a major loss of income in your business. There was a lot of backlash in the first stimulus package because the stimulus package was really designed for small business owners and payroll, but there wasn't really much benefits for certain individuals. So right now the government's actually released some more information and some more benefits for the wider community. So one such benefit is the early access of superannuation. So you can actually receive now, request $10,000 cash withdrawal from your superannuation account tax-free. But this only applies to people that are currently unemployed, or they receive some sort of Centrelink payment, or they have been made redundant recently, or they're working reduced hours and they've maybe a sole trader business and the turnover has reduced by more than 20%. So I think this is actually quite beneficial. Obviously, even though you are getting some benefits from the government, it may not be enough and you may have to make that decision. And it's an unfortunate decision, a very difficult decision of letting your employees go. You do have to let them know that there are some other ways they can get some benefits from the government. So one such benefit is to get them to register through MyGov and speak to the Centrelink to get them up to $550 per fortnight from the government. I know it may take a bit of time, but there are talks from the government that they said they're going to speed up this process as well. So hopefully that's quite a beneficial response by the government, because it's not just the business owners that are going to be affected, but the employees and individuals and family households out there as well. On top of that, they're also giving a second $750 payout to households that are in need of it. You don't need to do anything about this. I think that would automatically pay out to you if you're registered with Centrelink and receiving some sort of social security benefit from Centrelink. So as of last week, I believe the New South Wales government has also released their own stimulus package and basically said that for the employers that are paying payroll tax, for the next 3 months, their payroll tax is exempt and they don't need to pay any more payroll tax for the next 3 months, which is a major, major good news for those business owners out there that are paying a 5% payroll tax as a result of paying their employees. So definitely a good plus for the New South Wales government. Another thing that's also mentioned is that the banks are doing a lot of support for small business owners. So if you're having some issues with paying your bank loans or cash flow issues because you can't afford your business loans, not just your residential or mortgage, then it's best to speak to the major banks and ask them for a deferral of up to 6 months in regards to your loan repayments. Maybe they will even let you off in terms of the interest as well. So even if you don't think you need it now, it'd be a good idea to make that call anyway, because somewhere down the track in the next 3 months, you might need this this deferral. So best to speak to the bank now, find out more information about it to see if you meet the criteria, because just because you don't need it now doesn't mean in 6 months time you might need it. And plus, we don't actually know how long this is going to last as well. So it's a good idea to look into it and find out more information about it. So a big common question and topic that we're going to be discussing right now is payroll, staff and employment. So there's going to be a lot of questions and a lot of things that the small business owners are going to be doing right now, whether it's reducing your staff, reducing your payroll, reducing the hours, or sending some employees to work from home, or sending some employees in isolation because they are sick. So what are the responses and what you should be doing for your business to ensure that you're abiding by all the rules and you're not doing anything unfair and illegal with your employees? So the first question that a lot of business owners are asking is, what if my employees is sick, stuck overseas, or need to be isolated because of a sickness? If they're part-time or full-time, then that basically means that they're entitled to sick leave. So for whatever sick leave they have, they can take it up as sick leave. And if they have some annual leave, you can, and they can't, they don't have any more sick leave, they can take up annual leave as well. And if they have any more, then you can negotiate with your employee and more than likely pay him unpaid leave as a result of having to take off 14 days because of the isolation, or taking 14 days because of being sick. So that's one thing. So if you're planning to stand down an employee or make the employee redundant because there's not much work available for him, or there's not much profits or income or cash flow to pay this employee anymore, you first got to make sure that you speak to the employee and work out different types of steps to take before standing down the employee. So obviously, if you can maybe reshuffle them to another position or reduce their hours or have a chat to them and work out a solution. And if the last result is that that you have to let them go, then you can let them go as a result of that. But it's definitely best to speak to your accountant if you're planning to do something like this, because there are strict rules in place, especially in Fair Work. So check out the Fair Work website. But there are strict rules in place to ensure that you do this right. So definitely speak to your accountant or some sort of expert when it comes to standing down your employees. So what happens if there's a lockdown for your employees and for your business? So basically, a lockdown means that you have to close the business down due to unforeseen circumstances. So basically, the employer cannot be held responsible for something that they can't control. So in this case here, the government has forced a lockdown on the business, and as a result, the business had to close. So if you have to close the company and you can't pay your employees, there are not any requirement to pay your employees because this is forced upon you. The employees can discuss with the employer what they could do in terms of pay, in terms of taking some of their annual leave, or in terms of taking some of their sick leave if they were sick. But if there is a lockdown, more than likely you don't need to pay your employees because the company has to close. So if your employees want to take annual leave, they probably could take some annual leave during the lockdown. I believe that the best course of action is to be open and communicate to your employees and have some transparency with the current situation of the business, the cash flow, as well as the work required from them. So we've received a lot of calls from clients and small business owners about what's the recommended business strategy moving forward. We reckon for our clients, small business owners, that the best course of action is to maintain cash flow and reduce as much expenses as possible. So what I recommend is speaking to the tax office and asking for extension of tax liabilities and lodgements at least up to July or end of July 2020. What you also recommend is looking at your hours for your employees, and if the worst comes to worst, Speak to them and be transparent to them about reducing maybe the staff hours and reducing payroll so we can minimize the impact on the business, because cash flow, income for the business and activity for the business may have slowed down as a result of this. The banks and the government has been working on giving out more small business loans to business owners. So we recommend you speaking to the banks to see if you can defer your business loan repayments for up to 6 months, or even just your mortgage. If that's not possible, maybe getting out another loan to just keep the business afloat. What we also recommend is reducing your expenses as much as possible. So the most biggest expense for a business owner is more than likely their rent. So it's better to speak to the landlord and take your first initiative to have a chat to them to see if you can reduce the rent or maybe delay the rent for a couple months to 3 months to find out what's going to really happen with the Australian economy. We'd rather that than you just closing shop all of a sudden. So it's better to work out what we're going to do with the expenses, work out what we're going to do with the landlord. It's better to keep communication up and be transparent rather than just shut them out completely. The last thing is speak to your accountant so they can organize some sort of grants that are coming from the government. Obviously, the government has released a lot of information about what ways they can minimize the damage on their small business and the household, whether it's getting money from Centrelink, whether it's getting a claim back from the PAYG tax withholding for your small business, or even maybe you're taking money out of your superannuation. So definitely speak to your accountant or financial planner to work something out.